reception will be none other than the Bell River native, Evan Matthews. He wins the tip. It goes over to Collins. And in the fourth spot is going to be Junior Osantolo.
Woot woot. Former Knight.
Former Knight from Holy Names, a starting freshman for the Lancers. Errant pass, as we called his name. Well, wasn't in a ready position was Lean Phillip, as he was standing a little straight up, and Junior's pass goes errant. Lancers will start full court man-to-man. Already trouble, and a turnover by the Lancers and the Lions.
Sloppy start for both teams here, J.K. Definitely maybe some nerves here for your coming.
Well, I'd say 13 seconds in, we've got the highest statistic is turnovers.
Can anybody chuckle there, eh, J.K.?
All right, here we go. Enrico Deloretto gets it inbounds to Josh Collins. Switching defense now by the York Lions as they go man-to-man. Evan Matthews had a super game last night, very steady in the post and on the wing. Evan Matthews posting up. He's being guarded by Tefezic. Tefezic has him there. Evans goes to work, uses his left, gets it knocked away. 8 seconds on the shot clock. Collins goes high off the glass, can't get it to go. Big rebound by Osantolo. On the wing now is Tisdale. He goes hard to the basket. No call there. Tisdale's ball rolls off, and it's Lean Phillip off the rim. Can't get it controlled, but it is knocked out of bounds by Rodas. Boy, Tisdale went hard there. Good defense by Enrico Deloretto as David Tisdale, leading scorer for the York Lions, was denied.
Still got the Yeoman in there.
Well, when I played, they were the Yeoman. We have to be politically correct. They are the Lions now. Kick out to Lean Phillip. He started the game yesterday with a three-point play from the exact same spot. That must be the play the Lancers want to run to start each game, that they're 6'8", St. Martin native, to go ahead and knock it down from three.
I have a feeling, though, that might not be always the genre of play, but definitely great to see Liam Phillip getting a touch.
Rodas from the corner. Nick Tefezic with a rebound. Nice job by Tefezic. Just out-muscled Evan Matthews and Lean Phillip for that rebound. Defense provided by number 7, Raheem Isaac. Had to kick off. Did Josh Collins travel? And another turnover for the Lancers here. Two for them as Phillip gets called for shuffling his feet.
Coach Oliver stating in the pregame he wants a high tempo game. He wants his players in this mentally. He can't have any mental lapses early on to fall into a deficit against these York Lions.
Tefezic over to Rodas. Rodas being guarded by Deloretto. Tisdale out on top. He dribble drives, crosses over, kicks to the far wing. Shot goes up and off by Isaac. He can't get it to go. And now Deloretto, coming off a big scoring night last night. He goes right down the middle, right to the 10, and gets the basket. Lancers lead 5-2.
Kind of like Moses there, just parting the Red Sea and going straight to the basket.
No
there.
Help by the Lions. Not a very good demonstration of defense. Double team right at half, over the top, over to Radis. Radis to Tefezic. Tefezic gets it right back to Isaac. They play catch across the top. Nothing there as the Lancers are clamping down on defense. 7 seconds left on the shot clock. Lean Phillip is guarding Rodas out top. He goes right by him, left heaven. Evan Matthews a little bit late. Oh, Tefezic goes for the rebound dunk and can't get it to go. He's got a bit of a bandage and a strap on his right leg. The second-year player out of Riverside High School. Tisdale comes across the top. He kicks it inside. Nice jumper there by Isaac. He can't get it to go. Rebound comes to Matthews. Cleans the glass.
Heavy Matthews again off to a strong start, just like last night against the
Osantolo drives right baseline. Kisses it off the glass. Gets the hoop in the arm. Call made by Tim Cook out of London with the refereeing crew. Headed by Paul Carter, who's been reffing just over 1,000 years. He's supported by Kevin Greenwood.
1,000 years.
Osantolo had a double-double last night, rebounds and points, even knocked down 2 3-pointers. Oh, a cheapie for Isaac. Sorry, for Lean Phillip, who really did a nice job yesterday of staying out of foul trouble. Now, I did mention he played for the Canadian World University team, went over to China, Sinchon, China, and also played for the Canadian Pan American team, where he gained a whole lot of confidence. Tisdale with his first attempt from long range. It won't go. Controlled by the Lancers. Osantolo in the open court. Pass is knocked away by Tisdale.
Junior Osantolo getting in the action early here. Definitely pushing up pace, trying to, you know, get the cobwebs out here and get the Lancers off on a good start.
Straight box set by the Lancers on the inbounds. Collins goes over the top to Delaretto. Fires right away. Hits the bottom of the well. He's as hot as he was last night. 5 points for him. Lancers lead 10-2. Take a look at Coach Oliveri in his second year. Having been on the staff for over 12 years, may have to need a timeout if they don't score in this rotation. Inside they go. The look is to Zabrowski. Zabrowski picks up his dribble. Big mistake. Fires it off the backboard. It won't go. Lee Phillip clears the glass. Averaging a double-double last year. Here's one of his fortes. Takes it right down the middle. He attacks hard. Good no call. That can't be a call.
Oh,
that can't be a call.
Late call.
Oh,
it is a call.
God. And then,
the official right in front of it just lets it go, but the official on the far end of the floor, he figures it's a charge. And
well, the player ran by the defender, did not run through the defender. Tough look there as Lean Phillip was trying to avoid the contact. It looked to me like he did, but a nice job by Nick Tefezich. The Riverside product, as we mentioned, draws that foul. Tisdale goes to the basket. He kicks on the right wing. Won't go there. Substitution for the York Lions is number 21, Koldia.
That's Leon Phillips' second foul of the game.
Yeah, we won't see him until the second quarter now.
No, that's Yes, we're going to have him imagine we count a little more here to fill that big man position, guard Tvezic.
Only 3:20 gone in this first quarter here, so Leon Phillips will be missed as McQueen comes into the game. Great defense by him. Tvezic battling for the rebound, and he gets it. Nice work by Nicky, pulling down the offensive glass, giving a new 24-second shot clock to the Lions. Tisdale on the far right wing. I like this matchup on Rotimi Osuntolo. Isaac on top, being guarded by Matthews. That's an interesting matchup. Isaac goes about 6'4", and Matthews goes about 6'8", maybe 6'9", goes right by him there. As you see, there's his advantage. Must take dribble drive on him, and it takes Evan Matthews to the cleaners there. Nice work by Isaac to pick up his first basket, 6'3", 177. Long range by Enrico Delaretto, and he picks up another three-pointer. 8 points for him. He's got eight of his team's 13. 5:49 left.
You're going to want to stop five with him right now. You might get burned.
Ooh, scorched. Drive by Isaacs. It won't go. Fight for it, Buzz McQueen. Instead, Rotimi Osuntolo releases it off to Evan. Oh, so
wow.
Nice work there by Nick Tvezic to get back, but McQueen rips down the rebound, gives it to Delaretto on the wing. Delaretto could have released it. I think he was going to go for the flush. Nick said, not here, not now. 13-4, 9-point lead for the Lancers. Osuntolo will go to the bench. We see early action here by number 8, Anthony Otley. Otley is a Brampton native, played at Kilgore College.
Check that. That's 9, Ryan Christie.
Oh, Christie came in. Okay, my check right there. Yep. It's Christie is going to be the first rotation for our first chance for him.
Remind our listeners, we're available for any shout-outs. Let us know how we're doing, how you feel, who you're rooting for, where you're watching from. At ssnwindsor@hotmail.com. We're glad to love to hear from you.
Last night's contest, we had several write-ins on the SSN Windsor Hotmail link from British Columbia, from Sudbury, and also from Quebec. So we'd love to hear from you this evening. 14-4, 10-point lead for the Lancers. Isaac being hounded by Collins. Isaac gives to the right corner. Looks like he's got Zabrowski over there. Zabrowski shakes, rattles, and roll. Can't get it to go there as he uses up most of the shot clock, and that was Rodas. In the wing is Delaretto. He just sets and fires. Someone's going to need to guard him. He's scorching. Now, last year, here's just a little footnote. Isaac Kwan scorched the York Lions for 45 points, and it may have been the easiest 45 points in history. Delaretto is on his way to breaking that record by Isaac Kwan and his 45. Went on to lead the league in scoring last year, did Isaac Kwan. He's sorely missed, being replaced by a three-man rotation, Gabriel with the travel.
A three-man rotation you mentioned there is Collins, Delaretto, and Leon Phillip.
And it's all Delaretto doing it himself
exactly, in this game.
Right
now, Delaretto's got the trio on his back, and he's carrying him down floor.
17-4, and finally, Coach Tom Oliveri goes to the timeout. As he needs to cool down these Lancers. The only way he knows how is by calling a timeout. Now, Oliveri here in only his second year, but has been on staff for 12 years with the York University Lions.
And again, you got to love how Coach Oliver goes in these timeouts. He allows the players to talk for the first minute or so, and he allows the He allows the coaching staff to kind of think it over, and then he goes into the huddle, gives him a cool little pep talk, and lets him go back out to the floor. So, again, letting the players, you know, feel themselves out, especially early on in the season here with a few new faces.
Well, it's
a different
at this
transition
point
play.
That he really lets his captains do their work. So you'll see Josh Collins, you'll see Lean Phillip having a chat with the boys first, and then the coaches come in and fine-tune what needs to be done. At this point, Coach Oliver, wanting to keep the high-paced game going, he has gone eight deep, as we've seen McQueen, Gabriel, and Christie come into the game. McQueen is a transfer from the junior college programs down south. Gabriel is a first-year player out of Toronto, played at Jarvis High School, a perennial contending quad A school out of Toronto.
Year in, year out.
Year in, year out. And, of course, Christie led the nation in rebounding when he played for McMaster University. Steal is Del Rado, playing defense as well. Gives it over to Gabriel. We just called his number, coming from the Jarvis program, and Gabriel gets his first two assists to Del Rado. Trap again by the Lancers. They go over top with it. Hard to the basket. Can't get it to go on the flush attempt. Christie does push off. Good work there, and a hard attack to the basket is Coldea.
Give Coldea credit. He attacked the basket with authority and didn't second guess himself whatsoever, even with the open man available in the corner there for the three-point look.
Biggest player on the roster at 6'8", 220 pounds. He's in his second year from Toronto, Ontario.
It's a big boy.
Coldea will be counted on to counteract the Lancers' advantage in size with Matthews, Christie, and Rotimi Osantolo, and, of course, Lean Phillip for the Lancers. Biggest lineup that Coach Oliver has had in many, many years. Matter of fact, he describes this as their tallest lineup, and other coaches refer to them as how athletic they are. So if you get them big and you get them athletic, you're going to be tough to beat on any given night.
Particularly why they...
Whoa, that's interesting. Tim Cook wanted to have his touch. McQueen was saying, uh-uh.
Refs always want to get involved, too. They don't want you to hear the verbal stuff.
Easily the token pressure beaten by the Lancers. Del Rado looks to dribble drive. Oh, floats, throws up a floater. Who's the foul on here? Must be on Gabriel over the back as he was being boxed out by Radis. Full court pressure, man-to-man with a double attempt by the Lancers. Tisdale in the middle. He pulls and dribble. Oh, dribble spins. Looks to tough play and tough catch by Coldea. He can't handle it as it went flying off of his hands. Pressure up by Velisi. 2-2-1 by the York Lions. Easily broken and a foul. Gabriel goes hard to the basket. Coldea smacks him on the mullet.
Great penetration there by Gabriel, you know, getting that first quick step by baseline.
I give Coach Oliveri credit, and he's trying to make the adjustments here. His team is trailing 19-6. They're having trouble scoring. They have to make up for it on the defensive end. In many cases, a pressing team does not like to be pressed. In this case, the Lancers are not only taking on the press, they're taking on the press to score. Have taken it directly to the basket or rotated to open looks for Enrico Del Rado. Second attempt by Gabriel is no good. Rebound goes to Jamal McQueen. He kicks it out to Del Rado. Del Rado finds Junior Osantolo in the corner. Del Rado running the offense now, throws it away as Tisdale jumps into the lane. Tisdale goes hard, drives to the basket. There's a foul there on Del Rado. Unnecessary. Just caught the top of Tisdale's head. He was determined and went right to the rack. He leads his team in scoring. He's not great at going to the basket. He loves to be a spot-up shooter, but a nice exhibition there of going hard to the tin.
Coach Oliver a little beside himself there how that foul was called, but as clearly from our view, there was contact.
Averaging just under 17, we'll call it 17, at 16.9 a game last year, led his team in scoring in the preseason this year as well, right around that mark, just above 15. Makes good on both, narrows the lead now 19-8. Lancers lead with 3:34 left in the first quarter. McQueen fakes to the corner, goes back to the hot hand. A little bit of a double clutch there, and a rebound by McQueen. Doing great on the glass. Jamal McQueen, long arms of the law there. 6'4", up sky and high.
Filling it nicely there for Liam Phillip, who's on the bench over two fouls. But if Coach Oliver keeps seeing that, can't go wrong.
Jamal sporting a little bit of a different look tonight. He's gone with the faux hawk on the lid tonight.
something new and different. Keep things interesting.
I love this matchup here. As you see, the Lancers playing tough, extended defense. What defense by Christie up top. Beautiful work there as they forced the Lions into an errant shot by Ian Hindu. There's a name full of vowels there for you. Ian Hindu out of Mississauga. He is a first-year player at the point guard position, kind of helping Christie out, handling the ball. 2-2-1 pressure. Collins back into the game. Collins brings it over the timeline, flips over to McQueen. McQueen looks over top. He can see over top at 6'6". Good place for him to be. Drops to McQueen. He patiently waits for it down the top. Kicks over to Junior Osatolo. Finds Collins in the corner. He drives. Finds Evan Matthews looking up from the three-point range. Can't get it to go. He did hit it from there last night. McQueen goes to the basket. Soft little baby jumper by him.
It's got to be the hair, JK. It's got to be the hair.
23 points in the quarter already. Not a good defensive effort by the York Lions. Otley now in the game. He's going to guard Tisdale. So fresh legs on Tisdale all the time. They are in full deny on Tisdale throughout this whole match. Tisdale can't even find an opening. The rest of the Lions have to play offense themselves. Running layup. Nice work there by Coldia. That was Valesi. Still the pressure. Lancers go up quick and right by it. Token pressure at best by the Lions. Man-to-man is what they're in. 23-10. The Lancers are leading. Goes to Evan Matthews. He tips over to Otley. Otley can't get anything going. Junior Osatolo's waiting in the corner for a long-range two. He shoots and hits nothing but air.
Junior kind of in between there. He just maybe step back. You know, he's in that three-point area. Step forward, he's in that two. He kind of in between there and decides to miss. Probably off with a low touch.
You're that far back, you might as well put your toes behind the line.
Exactly.
It either becomes a poor long two or an unlucky three. I'd rather take the unlucky miss at three.
Any day.
23-10, 1:40 left. Lancers already scoring 23 in the opening quarter, showing lots of defensive pressure. And forced to come out and help is number 21, Coldia. He kicks over on the right wing to Tisdale. His first look in a long time. He wants to take Otley. You can know he's feeling it. You see the look in his eyes. 6 seconds on the shot clock. He's firing this. Instead, he kicks into the corner. Won't go there as it's just short. Tisdale comes out with a rebound. Floating jumper from three. It won't go. Time left on the clock. Enough for Collins to make a play here. Nice work.
Too easy by
Junior. There, another easy basket for the Lancers. 25-10. They're up 15. A minute left now in the first quarter.
The Lancers got the Lions rolling around here. Well, as you can see right there is a great example.
Robinson.
Not having your head in the game.
Look to go inside, trying to feed the hog inside there to Coldia. Coldia wasn't able to handle it. Nate Robinson, an addition to the York lineup this evening. Playing the 2-3 kind of hybrid position that he's in. Early look for him. Coldia off in the corner being guarded by Christie.
It's a foul there on Evan Matthews.
Evan Matthews over the top on Coldia, I think.
And that's something Coach Oliver's going to have to watch now because with Liam Phillips on the bench already with two fouls, and if Matthews picks up another quick one here, it gets to cause some sort of trouble from Oliver. He doesn't want to think about that right now.
Right, and it's only his first personal, but he's trying to say, and it's all ball. The ball went down, and he's trying to say it got all ball. It went down. Got to let that go. Coldia goes to the line. Can't make the first. The ball don't lie. Coldia going for his second, looking for the team's 11th. He gets it to go, 25-11, 53 seconds left in the first quarter. 2-2-1 pressure. Evan Matthews is back to help Collins break the press. Cutting to the basket now on the Lancers. Good defense by the York Lions as they now revert back to a 2-3 matchup zone. Christie and Matthews take the post. Collins, hang time, kicks it over to Junior Osatolo. He looks inside to Christie. Nice kick to Evan Matthews. Patiently, that's not a travel. He just jump stopped. He looked like maybe he must have dragged that back left leg. So Evan's had some hard luck here in the last two possessions. Foul at one end, travel at the other. Another turnover for the Lancers. Plays into the hands of the now having to come from behind York Lions.
Lions struggling here, trying to find any sort of momentum. Great pass work.
Oh, wow. Flush by Christie. Pass by Osatolo. Nice work by Collins to find Osatolo on the left wing. Quick tap pass to Christie. He flushes up in a quick hurry. 27-11. 6 seconds left. They better get a shot off here as Inahindu. What's the call there? Travel. So Lancers will get another shot at it. 1 second left. Look to Collins to fire the 90-footer.
Christy, they're looking to put an exclamation point on this opening quarter for the Lancers.
I am Hindu. Boy, that was a crazy just off, and that's a shot for Collins.
Wow. If he would have drained that, I don't know what I'd have done myself. Well, you got to say, though, Jake, after the opening quarter between the Lancers and Lions, the Lancers up 16. Got to be happy with the start the Lancers are having, but for the York Lions, they're struggling to find a rhythm, and you know that's due to Enrique Delorado and the mismatches that they're creating up front.
Well, not only that, and it is the mismatches that they're creating up front. You know, we have to call it for what it is, a 16-point advantage after 10 minutes of play. It really is up to the Lancers how they exert their will on the rest of this game. Maintain control of the ball. Reduce turnovers. Break the press to score. It should play into the hands of the Lancers because the early book on Coach Oliveri's York Lions is that they're not the best defensive team. Thus, they have to revert back to the 2-3, the gimmick 2-2-1 full court pressure. And unless you can bring it man-to-man in the OUA, you're not going to be able to compete at the highest level.
Well, you said it, JK. As you can see, Coach Oliver going back into his huddle here. The players knowing they're up 16, but he's got, I can tell you right now, he will stress to you right now, as a coach, you cannot let the York Lions back in this ballgame. You have the team down by 16. You cut a real deep and watch the blood spew all over right now. If you're the Windsor Lancers, you got to go hard the whole second quarter. There's no doubt about it. For the York Lions on the other end, though, they got to find some sort of rhythm because they can't keep doing this all game long. It seems to get out of hand real quickly. And when it does, you know, it's not going to be pretty.
Okay, I just want to write this down. You did say let the blood spew all over. That's why we have him in the color chair, ladies and gentlemen. That's Vince Oliveri. Give it a
I try my best. What can I say? Just getting everyone else. Wow, look at that blumber. For everyone out there and listening along on the webcast, please email us at ssnwindsor@hotmail.com. You know, just want to give us a shout out. Let us know how you're doing, who you're rooting for, who you're looking to see if you can pull out a win here. Maybe some of the keys. Some of the stats here from the first half. Enrique Delorado leading all scorers with 12 points. Phillip and Austin Tola both with 4 rebounds apiece. Big stat here, though. As you can see, the Windsor Lancers limiting the turnovers with 6, but holding the York Lions to 18.8 shooting percentage from the floor.
18% shooting. Great defense by the Lancers. Coldia inside against Christie. Christie stays down, and Coldia takes advantage of it, knocks it inside, knocks it down for 2 inside for him. Now they go. They're still in the 2-2-1 pressure. Good kick to Junior in the corner. Nice drive to the basket by Olsen Tolo, the holy name night product.
Whoop, whoop. Using all that 7-1 wingspan at a crowd to pass, and nice soft touch to finish off the play.
6'5 and a 7'1 wingspan. That's just amazing physicality. Hisdale just gets smothered, and he goes to the basket. Box out by Matthews. Outlet to Collins. Collins goes over to, nice drive, and he gets no call there, but a good hard drive.
Oliveri, quick to call a timeout there, knowing this is not exactly what we want to come out of.
First look for our home crowd for Henok Aria, and he is a third-year player, transfer from Malcolm X College. Lancers are shooting it at a 61% clip, and you can clearly see why. One pass, and nobody left to guard the house, and the floodgates are open as the Lancers are running in layups. Olsen Tolo on the last one, and Aria, who did not get a chance to play last night. The Lancers have now gone 9 deep on their bench.
Now, Coach Oliver earlier today in practice, as he was coming off the floor, really stressing to his players transition and better decision-making. Last night, they kept the Voyagers, kept around for a long time. And this tonight, you can tell the decision making is a little bit better. Maybe the cobwebs that hang over from a championship season, you know, finally cleared out of the way, and the Lancers are, you know, finally focused on that goal.
Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. And I just checked my stats. It's actually 10 players deep. So might we see a Michael Godfrey appearance or a Gerard Malcolm appearance this evening? Yet to be said, as the Lancers now lead 31-13 over the visiting York Lions.
I just said there, Michael Godfrey standing 6'6", 215 out of Wallacetown, Ontario. Went to West Elgin High School. Could be definitely see some more playing time if Matthews picks up a second foul here early in the second quarter.
Oh, nice steal ball. Almost a steal by Enrico Deloretto. Clock stays the same, 12 seconds. Lancers are in deny almost on all possession. Now, this isn't always a forte by Coach Oliver. He's not one to deny all the time, but York is susceptible to this. They run to spots. They don't necessarily make good reads off of these screens, so they have trouble when the team, when the opponent is denying them.
As you can see, again, another denial there on the inbound. But as you said, they're right in the spots. Sometimes you got to use, you know, stop thinking too much and just kind of let the game come to you.
While it's tough, Robinson is a freshman having to inbound it here as he does find a way to get it into number seven, Isaacs, who comes over to Tisdale. Tisdale goes right by Gabriel, finds it off the glass. Gabriel needs to get him to spot up, not allow him to dribble drive. I take that back. He is a spot up shooter, so he makes him drive and he does complete it. Gabriel on the deep right baseline. Phillip back into the game. That's a travel.
Right. I'm just as confused as you are, J.K. But though the Lancers, though, having Liam Phillip playing so high up, really not using, you know, if you can hit it from the outside, it's great. But you really want to use the established position down low, possibly even giving more looks to you know, to Enrique Deloretto and to Josh Collins there from outside.
Lancers have Collins and Deloretto in the backcourt, Christie and Osantolo on the wings, and Liam Phillip manning the post. So formidable lineup here for the Lancers.
Sign-up seemed to work pretty well there in the
on top
ladder
is
half.
Bachman. He slid into the game for Coach Oliveri. He's now gone eight deep on his bench. Robinson has it up top, gives to Christie. So, yes. Sorry, check that, not Christie. That was Bachman again. Hard to see as Kevin Greenwood makes a better door than he makes a window. Deloretto picks up his first, I believe, foul, second personal foul. So Deloretto just has to be a little bit careful there. Reaching in didn't help him at all. Hands on ball. The Lancers almost have a mindset that they're going to push, shove, grab, and hold until you make a call. And Deloretto did get called there. Practicing some of those dark arts, shoulders, elbows, hips, and knees. Bachman has it on top, gives to Caldilla. Cutting back door, goes for the pass, and not complete is a pass to Nubala Muhammad, a second-year player out of Toronto, made the right decision, but Caldilla did not deliver the backdoor cut, the backdoor pass. Justin Bell now into the game. Boy, Coach Oliveri has just said, if you guys can't do it from the first unit, I'm subbing the boys in, and he's got now deep as Nick Tefezich is in, and so is Justin Bell down low on the post. Christie working on him there. Good patience, gives it to Deloretto. 6 seconds on the shot clock, Deloretto's got to take. Instead, he kicks to Lean Phillip. Nothing there for him as it just goes a little bit long. Battling for it is Christie. Nice work for him. Another rebound for Christie. Lean Phillip down low on the baseline. Needs to clear that zone. He does. Doesn't get called for three in the key. They've gone token 2-3 pressure as Junior fires it from long range. Collins tips it to himself.
Very athletic play there, J.K.
Just found a way to get the ball there, being guarded by Nabil Muhammad. 2-3 zone by the Lions and looks inside to Junior. He comes inside back to Christie. Can't get it to go. They look at it. I don't like that. You know what? One player needs to step up and just say, my bad. There's a little bit of angst between those players right now.
Coach Oliver having his head, you know, hangs his head and goes, oh, yeah, you know.
Yeah.
Sometimes too much time on searching.
One of the things that I don't like is your team is winning by 16 points, 31-15. Lions have come alive a little bit here, and they've got the Lancers kind of bitching and moaning at each other. They're driving their BMWs, bitch, moan, and whine. Firing from long range. Won't go as Muhammad. Big rebound. Easy look on the inside is Redis. Coach Oliver won't be liking that. He needs Lean Phillip and McQueen to box out. Clear glass.
Coach Oliver letting his players know he's not happy with what he sees right now.
Junior Osantolo gives to Enrico Deloretto. Ball faking over to Collins. He goes. The zone is extending itself over top. Oh, Junior just got it messed up in the mesh, actually, and threw his catch off ever so slightly.
Really nice to see completed.
Down court
there
is Bachman. Bachman looks inside. He can't get it to go. Long rest for Tisdale on the bench right now as Coach Oliveri is giving him an earful on the bench right here. Collins fires from long range. It's errant. Rebound goes out of bounds. Chance now for the visiting York Lions to cut into this lead. 31-17, Lancers lead. 6 minutes left in the second quarter.
Again, Coach Oliver pulling his players across, especially Liam Phillips, saying, I don't understand what you guys are doing here. Kind of confusing, you know, should be trying to pull away a little bit more. But give credit to Oliveri. Go and do any matters he can to really, you know, keep this game close.
Well, I'm just checking the stats here. Other than Radis and Tefezic, he's only got two starters in there, and these guys have made a bit of a run as it's 31-17. Radis looks left, goes back to the right, goes up with the right hand. It won't go. Ball's fouled on the ground, being held on the ground. Looked to me like he was going to score. What's the call?
I'm not too sure. I'm trying to figure it out.
All travel? I think he was called for a travel. 24 White with the hold. There was a reason why Radis was able to go by Otley so easily there. It's because he was being held.
Yeah.
And I think when Justin Bell grabs onto it, he's 6'6", 230, and they're being generous at 230. That guy's 250 if I've seen anybody. He's a big, big man.
He has those bear claws. He just grabs right on you.
Meat hooks at the end of his wrists. Nice work by Jamal McQueen and a kick. I believe that was from Otley there. So nice sharing of the ball by the Lancers. 33-27. Although they've cooled off ever so slightly, they're still in a commanding lead. Defense inside by the Lancers. Nick Tefezic fires it, and Radis comes up for the rebound for the Lions. Tefezic and Radis have been very good on the offensive glass. Fire from outside is Bachman. Hit won't go for him. Rebound is Muhammad. He loses it. And in transition now is Deloretto. Deloretto goes behind the back. Deloretto goes hard with the left hand. Can't get it to go over the ring. That thing was shot 9 foot 11 inches. Got to get it at least 10 feet in the air. Foul is Deloretto. 33-17. You seem to like that one there, Biddy.
Oh, I know. I got a couple.
Just took you had to do the math on that, didn't
yes,
you?
Yes, I had to. Like, oh, yeah, that makes sense. One more inch makes 10 feet. Oh, that makes total sense.
33-17. Simple math we do here on the sidelines of the SSN Network. 4:52 left in the half.
You never cease to amaze me. Oh my lord.
Radis inbounds to number 23, Bachman, seeing lots of time as Tisdale has been sent to the pine. Leading scorer has been resting here for the York Lions. Muhammad from the outside. It won't go. They've gone cold from the outside. Travel on Otley, but it looked like, you know what? And it was only because he was battling his own teammate, Lean Phillip, who just bumped him enough and knocked him off stride. Another turnover for the Lancers. They started the first quarter with turnovers. They are now starting the second quarter with turnovers. But remember, they went on that explosive run to score. Am I right? Was the 31 scored in the first quarter? What was their score in the first quarter?
First quarter here we had 27 scored in the first quarter.
So they've only scored 5 here in 5 minutes, so they've definitely gone off that blistering pace they had in the first quarter.
Wow. Though to their credit, though, they've only held the York to 6 points themselves. So
Tyndale is back in the game for the York Lions, as well as Justin Bell on the far side. He kicks up top to Bachman. Bachman being guarded by Otley. Bachman comes across the foul line to Nick Tefezic. Tefezic goes backdoor. Long arms of, Junior Asantolo just reached out that big long arm. Rodas goes to the basket. He gets it to go. Good shifting shot by him as McQueen was just ever so late getting there. He did come for the help out defense. Tip of the cap goes to Aaron Redis as he knocks that one in, and a good dribble drive.
Just seem to hang up in the air there all day there, JK.
14-point lead for the Lancers. 2-3 zone by the Lions again. We should probably stop saying it. That looks like they're all going to play today is zone defense. Pass by Collins. Goes to Phillip. Phillip goes up. Can't get it to go as he had Radis in the air. And Radis picks up his second personal foul.
He also is probably taking a big breath of air there because he got the wind knocked out of him as he comes down right in the shoulder of Liam Phillip. And as by all means, Liam Phillip is not a tiny man at all. Standing all of 6'8", 215, the third year forward out of IMG Academy.
Yeah, he's 6'8", and he's 215, and he's got about a 4% body fat.
Yeah, that's definitely not someone you want to have. That's a guy you want to have on your team, but you dread to play against.
He's cold on a summer day, that boy.
Oh, I love the Lions, Jake. I gotta love them.
Oh, nice rebound by Ali. Powers it up over Tefezic and gets credit for the foul as well.
Check that. That
Nick Tefezic is beside himself. He can't figure out why he got that call, and I think this is Nick's second. He may have been Mr. Basketball for Riverside, but he's not Mr. Basketball in this gym. As Paul Carter says, Nicky, not here, not when you're visiting home. And it's his third foul, so he's in trouble. He's going to need to go to the bench.
Just check that, though. That was Christie, not Ollie, that drew the foul, but still.
Well done, Christie. Thank you.
You're more than welcome,
Jake. You correct me again, and I'll banish you to the sideline.
I don't think we get any closer to the court, though, JK.
With our camera quality, eights look like nines to me. Three fouls for the visiting Lions, two for the Lancers here, 33-19, 3:47 left in the half. Christie can't make the next one, but that is Otley.
He gets
the offensive rebound. Lancers have been very active on the offensive glass. Now they're just going token man-to-man pressure. It is their signature. Their defensive DNA is a man-to-man pressure. Fire there is by Bell. He can't get it to go, but picking up the loose ball are the Lions. Hard to the glass. Over the back is got to be Koldia. Looks to me like number 21, Koldia, will be called for over the back. Lions having to go to the tin offensively because their only offense they're going to get is on second chance opportunities. Can't seem to get it to go here. 35-19, Lancers lead.
Just a reminder there, folks, anyone listening to the broadcast, please, we want to hear from you. Any comments, thoughts, even a shout-out, just let us know at ssnwindsor@hotmail.com. Glad to hear from you. Glad you're along for the ride. JK and myself, Vince, will bring you all the action right here courtside at the St. Dennis Center.
Collins goes down hard, hits his back and head on the new standards that they put in here at the university. Previous baskets are still up in the ceiling. They spent about $100,000 to get these new baskets for both the practice facility and the game time. And Collins comes off of the ground, gets the steal, kicks to Lee Phillip in a corner. He drains a three. So maybe they knock some sense into him to make that good pass out there for Collins to Lean Phillip.
Then know what? And that's what makes Lean Phillip so dangerous. You don't want to play him on the inside. We're playing right to the outside. Don't drain him from outside. So.
And here he is playing defense on Raddus way out on the basket. Koldia goes back door to Christie. He can't get it to go. Turnover is him. Collins has control of it. A little bit late on the pass. Rotimi Osantolo gives it to Lean Phillip. He goes to the basket. Fancy left-handed instead of just shooting it. Oh, Osantolo can't get it to go either. Both of them playing above the rim but can't get that thing to drop. 38-19. Now 2 minutes left in the quarter.
You got to wonder, though, JK. Maybe you got to just slam that home instead of, you know, finger rolling like maybe Phil did there.
Playing below the rim like I did, I don't know what you're talking about. Lean Phillip being our guards. Koldia can't get it to go. Pushed out of the way is Raddus. Rebound in loose ball goes to Collins. Collins dribble drive. Kicks to the corner. Nice shot by Junior. It won't go. Just a little bit long. Rebound goes to Bell. Bell gives it over to Tisdale. Check that. That's Bachman. Bachman taking over some of the ball control duties for Tisdale. Tisdale's being blanketed by Junior Osantolo. Nice matchup there as Tyndale is only 5'11", Junior 6'5", and the long arm reach. Bachman has it at the top, being guarded by Collins. Bachman goes right by Christie. Got to be a charge. Yes, it is. Nice work by Otley. Stepped right in there. Super defensive effort there. Coaches love it when their players take the offensive charge.
Lancers have broken the lead, busted the lead up to 19 points right now. So definitely going to see what Coach Oliveira, I don't know what else he can really do. He subbed in pretty much his whole bench, different combinations, different looks than the Windsor Lancers, but the Lancers still find a way to keep producing points. So, you know,
well, they
Coach
did
Oliveira
cool off, obviously, from that first quarter.
Yes.
Tough to keep up that torrid pace, but 38-19, Lancers lead. Into the game now for the Lancers is King Gabriel. Gabriel kicks it over to Otley. Otley and Collins play catch. Give it over to Matthews. Medium range jumper. Man, they become tough when their bigs can hit those medium range jumpers as Evan Matthews, the Bell River Noble, demonstrates right there, 40-19. 1 minute left now in the quarter.
Something sweet about that left-handed stroke, though. Just kind of makes it look that much more pretty.
Koldia picks up the dead ball. He can't get it to go. Long range shot attempt by Isaac. He can't get it to go. Hasn't played in quite a while. Otley Oh, and Evan Matthews. Matthews goes with the right hand. The lefty can't get it to go. You need to flush that thing, son. And a block shot inside as Otley is battling for it. Head fake for him and finally gets the foul. Evan Matthews is beside himself. He can knock down the three and the mid-range jumper, but God forbid he makes a right-handed layup.
Oh, my. And you got to wonder, like, he's that high in the air. Why don't you just slam it home and send a
It
point?
Looked like he was good. He got wrong-footed just ever so slightly. He's a natural lefty. Spent a little bit of too much time tipping cows this morning. I guess he just wasn't able to make that thing go.
Fall River native, though, has really produced really strong through the preseason, adding that as a sixth man, that Coach Oliver can really go to. Now what he's even now picked up that fourth spot with the trio of Collins, Delaretto, and Lean Phillips. So definitely.
Well, one of the interesting things about Evan is that he played hockey right up till grade 9.
He did. That's correct.
And really didn't get a lot of basketball experience. He started playing for the Riverside Falcons travel program under Coach Rick St. Pierre and blossomed with him and Pat Osborne as their coach, and has been the biggest surprise for the Lancer over the last 2 years. 22 seconds left. Nice rebound and put back by the Lancers. Rodas goes to the basket. Looks like he's held by Christie. What is Christie doing there? Kind of a silly foul with 18 seconds
Definitely
left.
Definitely not happy with himself there.
Yeah, 43-19. I give Radis some credit there as he just dribble drove and just went until somebody was going to try to step up to stop him. And the only way they did was by grabbing on. Josh Collins goes to the bench. Now we've had that sighting, ladies and gentlemen, as Henrik Aria is into the game as well. Lancers have gone 11 deep. Evan Matthews picks up a foul far from the basket. You do want to close out on Christie. He's a great spot-up shooter. Evan just went at the wrong hand there and just ended up throwing his body weight into him. He picks up his second. Not real foul trouble there as there's only 15 seconds left. 43-19 for the Lancers.
Almost reminiscent of last night, though, J.K., at the end of the first
You're right.
half. That four-point play, put the Voyagers right there on the doorstep, going into halftime. So, a little bit of a bigger lead here. But, again, still not what Coach Oliver wants to see towards the end of a half.
Absolutely right. Tyndale shoots it at a 70% clip from the foul line. Makes good on the first two. Doesn't get the trifecta, but he does almost come up with a loose ball. Yes, he does with a little push off. Fighting for it is Aria. And jump ball goes to the Lancers. 11 seconds left. Interesting that Coach Oliver chose to take out Collins, their consummate floor general, and Delaretto on the bench here to finish off the half. Leaves it to King Gabriel to run it here with 10 seconds on the clock.
Giving Gabriel some experience there running the court, even if it's just for a few seconds.
Oh, nice split of the pins there. Going to get called for the charge. Travel. Yeah, he did jump hop. You can make that move in the NFL. You can't make it in the OUA. That jump hop is a great move for a first down, but you're going to have to keep dribbling. Otherwise, you're called for the travel. 3 seconds left. Just a chance. Outside chance that it is, but a chance for the Lions. There it is. Make that. Oh, he should have shot it earlier. Yep, should have caught and shot. Otley knows it. Unlucky for him. Well, ladies and gentlemen, a good comeback, actually, effort by the Lions, but the counterattack by the Lancers, they now lead 43-21, 22-point lead for the Lancers going into the intermission. I'm J.K. Kennedy calling the play-by-play action. My counterpart and in the colored chair is Vince Eliberti. We'll be back in 15 minutes to call the second half, give you all the stats and keep you updated. We'd love to hear from you. Vinny, how can they get a hold of us?
Yes, if you guys are out there, just want to comment on how we're doing, or even just giving a shout out there to anyone out there and on the webcast, let us know how we're doing at ssnwindsor@hama.com. Glad to hear from you. We've gotten from all over, from Israel to BC. So let us know where you're calling from, where you're emailing from, who you're rooting for, and, your shout out. So that's for JK and I. We'll see you in about 13 minutes.
Thank you. guys.
Thank you.
Welcome back, Lancer fans and your York Lion fans. I'm Vincenzo Liberti bringing you the stats there from the end of the first half. Enrique Delaroto leads all scorers with 12 points. He has one rebound as well during the ballgame. Led also chipping offensively also for the Windsor Lancers. Rotimi Hasantolo chipping in with 6 and Liam Phillip with 6. They both have 5 boards apiece. Anthony Ollie leads the Lancers with six boards. Lancers shot 48.6% in the opening half. Free throw percentage is kind of dismal, 18.2, and their three-point percentage, 41.7. On the York Lancers, or the York Lancers, York Lions, excuse me, for our folks, leading the way was Nick Tefetich, had 5 rebounds, 2 points chipped in there, right behind David Tindio, who had 6 himself. The York Lions shot a little bit better there from the free throw line, 77.8%, but still a dismal 22.6 from the floor, and a surprising 0-for-12 from beyond the arc. So Coach Oliveira definitely looking for something here to spark his Lions here early in the second half. And Coach Oliver, like I said earlier, is going to look to his trio to open the lead up here, open it pretty wide. And you know, again, like I said earlier, watch the blood spew all over as their opponents.
Both teams go with their starting lineups here, Vinny, so nothing's changed there, although the York Lions need to get their starters off and rolling. We did say that Delaroto had his 12 at half. Interesting. He had those in the first quarter when we kiboshed him and said that he might get close to Isaac's 45.
Then no one that makes that just shows how truly special at 20, that 45 really is.
Fair enough. From the outside is Koldea. He can't get it to go. Unlucky for him. Sorry, that was Zabrowski. Collins up top, kicks over to Osantolo. They play catch over top. Inside to Evan Matthews. He kicks to the wing. Lean Phillip takes it there. Looks like he gets called for the travel. A little bit of shake and bake. Goes for nothing. They start with the turnover.
Lean Phillip always so explosive off the ball. That first step is always so dangerous. And for a big man, he's very, very graceful when he has the rock in his hand. So great to hopefully Phillip can turn it around.
Isaac brings it over the timeline. Almost turns it over. Koldea has it now. He gets stopped by Evan Matthews. Look inside is Zabrowski. Zabrowski fires on a fadeaway over Lean Phillip. It won't go. Lean Phillip clears the glass.
Trying to go old school there. No, kiss off the glass, fading away.
Despite losing or trailing by 22, the York Lions stay in the 2-3 zone. So if it doesn't work, stick with it. Collins over to Osantolo. Osantolo fires for the 3. It won't go. Evan Matthews gets pushed. It's not going. Good call by Tim Cook.
Great officiating there. The baseline official couldn't see who knocked the ball out there, but the silent official here, always right on top of it, letting know it's Lancer ball.
Beautiful stroke by Osantolo. If there's one part of his game that I've watched over the years that's improved, it's incredible how good that three-point stroke has been for him.
Very fortunate to watch him in the Holy Names product. When he went to Holy Names, we'll always love watching him shoot the rock.
9 points for Osantolo. He's out on the wing on Tyndale. Gets it right back. Fires Evan Matthews all over him there. Great hedge work by Evan Matthews. And although the horn goes off, there's the dunk by Evan Matthews. That's a lot better as the horn goes off, but the referee's whistle did not. That means you keep playing. Evans broke out after guarding Tyndale on the wing. Oliveri has seen enough as 5 unanswered points by the Lancers here, 48-21. He's got to come out of this zone, and that may spell poison for him as they're not a great man-to-man team.
You got to love, though, Evan Matthews, you know, really solidifying himself in that fourth spot, taking the rock and just flushing her home. You got to love that, you know, intensity, getting the bench to their feet and getting the hometown crowd here on their feet, you know, loving the dunks.
4 points for him, and as we said, Delaroto yet to score in the second half, second quarter, so he's gotten into a bit of a scoring drought. We must mention, though, that Coach Oliver, I believe, went 11 deep in the first half, so really spreading out the minutes, the playing time for all of his players.
Lancer cheer squad clearing the floor here, always providing that that pump-up action in between breaks. Lancer's coming out with Collins, Delaroto, Matthews, Phillip, and Osantolo, starting 5.
Yep, looks to me of the dressed players. Now, Joey Ellenberger from Brennan High School, he's dressed and on the bench but not eligible to play as you can only play 12 players. Butler is also hurt with a growing injury. Oh, that's a travel. Got away with it. Junior picks up the steal. Has could have thrown it up. Should have thrown it right up for Junior after he gets that steal. Lane Phillip, high dribble, won't go off of the 24-second clock.
You know what, Jake?
He tried banging it up the clock.
Here we've seen four games.
Yeah.
I got to say, at least once in every game, there's been something that always kind of amazes us in there.
There it was, right there.
Pounds off the floor, and he goes 25 feet high. So
these new Jared standards that the university has purchased here have been phenomenal. Rodas in the open court. He kicks over to... Oh, nice pass off. Inside is Zabrowski. He can't get it to go. Nick Cefezic picks it up, and he knocks it in on the offensive rebound. Timeout does pay dividends for Coach Oliveri, but he's still in the 2-3 zone.
It's big here to see how Lindsay is going to respond after that Cefezic two-ball down low.
Nice passing by Phillips to Evan Matthews. Medium range jumper won't go off on the rim. It's Isaac. Isaac chases it down inside, looks to big Nick Tvetich. Tvetich goes to work, pulls it around right-handed, can't get it to go. Rebounds is Collins. Nice for the guards to come down and rebound. Collins comes across that timeline, pulls up at the three-point line. Guarded there by Tindell. Fires Enrico Delaretto now picking up, heating it up. He is another three-pointer for him. 51-23 for the Lancers.
Again, similar to last night. He kind of goes cold there in the second quarter, but then turns on in the third and fourth. So hopefully he can carry that on the rest of the third and into the fourth quarter.
Push on Delaretto there, going for the attempted steal. I believe that's going to be his third. No, it's on Collins. It's on Collins, and it's his first.
Collins' first foul. That's correct.
The way Delaretto turned around, looks like he was pleading his innocence. Wasn't me, and they did give it to Collins. Isaac to Tvetic. Back door to Tindell. Tisdale goes to the basket and gets it.
Rotation there by Matthews, just a little late there.
Yeah, and overplay, that's what you ask of Osuntolo to do on the wing. He's got to get help for the back door cut on that and didn't get it by Matthews early enough. Starters for both sides. Fire by Delaretto. Hits the corner of the rim and the backboard. Won't go. Isaac across the timeline being guarded by Osuntolo. That's what he did last night against Manny Pasquale in knocking many of those balls away. You cannot cross over in front of this guy. His hands are so active defensively.
Yeah, 7'1" wingspan definitely made the Pasquale brothers, made for a nightmare for the Pasquale brothers last night. And I'm actually quite surprised there, Jake. He didn't throw the Eli Pasquale in there.
Fair enough, as he did
a few times there last night.
Wholesale substitution, front court gone for the Lancers. And Christy McQueen and Gabriel come in. Lancers now go with a three-guard rotation in Delaretto, Gabriel, and Collins. Hand check foul by McQueen, I believe, on the right baseline. Sorry, that's on Christy. He gets called with the push, his second one.
Again, fans, and those of you listening on the broadcast, please let us know how we're doing, who you're rooting for, and just even a shout-out. Let us know at ssnwindsor@hotmail.com. Glad to have you along here, as always.
Travel violation. That's an interesting call by the veteran referee Tim Cook out of London, as Aaron Raddus was a little bit haggard on the baseline and shuffled his feet. It's just like a play on the regular court. You cannot travel. You can pivot, but you cannot shuffle your feet. 51-25, Lancers lead.
Referee Tim Cook there at the other end of the floor wasn't too happy about Zabrowski's pass to him after he gets called for that travel. Little zip on there.
Oh, interesting.
Let him know how he feels.
Yeah, I didn't catch that. Nice work, Vinny. Isaac across the timeline being guarded and double-teamed here. Oh, nice help by McQueen. Rebound is Christy. That's a strong rebound in a crowd. We call that a dirty rebound. Delaretto now taking control at the top. 2-3 zone by the Lions. How strange. Gabriel in the middle of the paint. Over to Collins. He fires 4 feet behind the line. Catches the front of the rim. That's probably about apt for that shot as Tvetic is down. His right ankle is hurting. He's been grunting it out here most of the time. His ankle is definitely hurt. That right ankle, he's limping. He's already got it pasted up. And rebound comes to the Lancers. Jamal McQueen gives it to Collins. Collins with the mouse guard hanging half out. Wants Gabriel to come up. He does. turnover by the Lancers. Not good execution there. Tyndale goes to the basket. Did he just lose it? I think he did. I think he just plain lost it.
Shouldn't hide that popcorn there, JK.
Oh, exactly. The old watermelon seeds. Whoop, it's gone.
Looks like Tevet is just favoring that left ankle a little bit there. Not the right one he hurt, but even the left one, you know, kind of managed that one. But I'm surprised, though, for a big man who wears very low-cut shoes.
Yeah, they're kind of that three-quarter Adidas look that he's got on there. I'm not sure the support that he gets.
Some teams in the NBA actually, JK, ban the kind of shoe because they see the high ankle rollovers happen far too often for their players.
Spot up by Otley. He goes hard to the basket. There's nothing but bodies down below. A scrum breaks out in the middle of the basketball game. Foul is here.
Except for I tell the boys they're playing basketball, not rugby.
I think it's going to be on... Yep, his first personal on Vlad Velitsi.
Christy coming up with a little wince on his face, but such up the hamstring seems to be okay.
Vlad looks a little out of his element here, as most of the Lancers have been on Frank Jenny's weight training program, and they are big and strong inside. Christy goes to work. He gets it knocked away. Radich over to Tyndale. Tyndale goes hard to the basket. This time he does finish. Good, strong work for him.
So a shout-out here for Cheryl Solomon, just saying...
All right, well done by the Lancers here as they've got to come back and counteract Tyndale and his hard drive to the basket. Coming a little closer now is Tyndale to his 15-point average this year, 16 for last. McQueen fires from the rim, doesn't use his legs, doesn't get it to go. Tyndale gets the loose ball. Boy, he's like a bullet shot out of a gun when he takes off with that ball. Kicks it over the crop top to Isaac. Isaac fires. It's nothing but the bottom of the well. Nice work between the guard tandem of Tyndale and Isaac. 51-30, 21-point lead, only slightly cut in by the Lions here. Need the balance on the floor. Oh, and an errant pass. Gabriel goes hard to help out, but he can't get it as there's the timeout. As now the lead has been cut to 19.
Like I said earlier there, Jay, it's big on, Lance's got to make sure they put this Lions team away. And they're still kind of hanging around. Low 19 is a big lead. Still very, very surmountable to bring back. Just a shout-out here to... Cheryl Solomon, want to say hello to all the New York Lions, and especially Justin Bell, number 24. Shout out from London, Ontario.
Well, I don't know. I wonder what the relationship is. Cheryl and Justin there. I don't know what's going on.
Not too sure, but either way, glad to thank you for tuning in and for giving us a shout out. We'll gladly give you one here on the air.
Well, there you have it, ladies and gentlemen. We are in the middle of the third quarter, the tail end, actually, of the third quarter, 51-32. The Lancers have... started the game at a blistering pace of 23 points scored in the open. 27 in the opening quarter, and the rest of the way they've now scored 26.
Yes.
No, less than that. Wait a minute. I got to do the math. It's 24 for the rest of the way. So, gone into a drought, and I think part of that is attributed to the zone defense that the Lancers are competing against by the York Lions, and this just causes them to slow down that game, 2-3 passes in. They're using more of the clock than they generally do. So in a way, they've played into York's hands, but York hasn't been able to then create turnovers off of that soft defense. They've only been able to slow the Lancers down.
Could have said it better than myself there, Jay.
Also, Tolo, lean Phillip back into the game with Evan Matthews. Also into the game, number 14 for the Lancers, Ariya. So Lancers answering with a few of their bench players. Lean can't get it to go from long range. His three-point attempt is not good. Patience may be needed there by the Lancers. Just even an extra pass to find an opening by Lean Phillip.
Coach Oliver kind of beside himself there, trying to wonder what he has to do for his boys to come out of timeout well.
Yep, and you really want your team to execute well out of a timeout. Take heed of your tutelage. Nick Tefezic cannot handle the loose ball. The errant pass goes over the top. Collins gets hammered to the ground. And the Lions are all over them. No, it's not. Oh, wow. Tim Cook calls over and back. But it's looked to me like a loose ball swat there. Could have went from anybody, but it came off of Collins' hand. And Gabriel had to go to the backcourt to pick that up. Check that. That's Aria had to go to the backcourt to pick that up.
The wet spot here on the floor there, Jay. They're just going to wipe that up there quickly. But, yeah, there was about four or five bodies on the floor.
Best move Paul Carter's made all day. 51-32, 3:26 left in the third quarter. 13 minutes of action. So these are the turnovers that the Lions must take advantage of. They trail by 19. Tyndale, oh, goes right by Asatolo. Help is late by Lean Phillip, but enough to change the shot by Tyndale. Cullen sees him with that mouth guard half hanging out. I'm not sure why he's got it in. He's got to put that thing away. It just looks funny there as he kicks over to the right way to Aria. Aria travels. Yes, he does. Gets bumped a little bit. Good defense by Raddatz there. Just wouldn't be pushed off of the ball as you saw Aria driving to the basket. Turnover to the Lancers. Aria picks up his second turnover. He's a Malcolm X College graduate, transfer. He is in his third year and just seeing a limited time here for the Lancers thus far.
Again, Coach Oliver, he's saying, come on, doesn't know what he has to do to get his players here motivated on the offensive
Great
end.
Great defense by Collins on the inside. Half front to full front, knocks it away as Raddatz had him outsized on the post. No sense staying behind him. Get it front, get the turnover, and he did. Aria just a little slow in developing a play for Collins. He gave him a little bit of the business,
wow.
Gets the pass back. He's telling him to move. Collins is a pesky floor general out there, not giving any love to Aria. He knocks down the three, 54-32 for the Lancers.
That was a deep three, too, there, Jay.
Oh, yes, just like his last one. It didn't go. This one did. Tyndale to the basket. Nick Tvecic. He goes hard off the pass from Tyndale.
Cuts the lead back down to 20 for the Lancers.
Collins wants his wings to be out of the corner. It's too far to pass on the 2-3 matchup zone. Aria with the nice hesitation. Pull-up jumper. Won't go. Rebound to Phillip. He can't get it to go. Rebound and loose ball pulled down by Osantolo. Passing spot for Lean Phillip. He throws it right into the hands of the waiting Isaac. Isaac has Tyndale. Tyndale doesn't get it, but Isaac does. He goes right to the 10. Decoy was Tyndale, and Collins had to pay attention to him. Nice job by Isaac to take it to the basket. 18-point lead for the Lancers, 54-36. Collins is a little frustrated here. I'd like to see him show a little bit of support. He's still working with some young players out there. Good high-low action for the Lancers as Evan Matthews cuts to the top. Wants him to come up top, and Lee Phillips slides into the post. Picks up a foul for number 12, Velasi.
Evan Matthews will check out of the game as Jamal McLean comes in. As you said, though, great high-low rotation.
And Aria goes out for Deloretto. Deloretto in the corner. Good decision-making there by the Lancers. A little bit of patience. 9 seconds on the shot clock now. Finds Deloretto. He steps right into it. Fires, just misses. Lean Phillip for the rebound. Up strong with it. And Nick Tvecic just cannot elevate off of that bad ankle. We're guessing as to which one it is. We're going to call it both on bad wheels or a little bit of air out of both tires. Isaac goes to Raddatz. Raddatz on the right wing. Hard drive on Deloretto. He's going to get called for the foul. Yeah, you have your hands up and you bumped him the whole way, says Timmy Cook. Easy call for a referee to make.
I was reading Timmy's lips there. Yeah, Deloretto's trying to plead his case the whole way. That'll be his fourth foul, so.
Let's hope that he's not in law school because his case will not be heard.
Not at all. That would have been tossed out quite early.
Raddatz. Ooh, just off to the right side for him. Hard luck for him as he had 4 points in the first half. Was looking good off the start. Looking for his fifth. And the first appearance of Gerard Malcolm. Jared is 6'4", 185 pounds from Whitby. He came from Iowa Central College, so one of the junior college transfers here. And interesting that he's in the game, another one of those long bodies for the Lancers.
Very versatile. Coach Oliver has a few of those bodies on the team.
Three seconds. Well, Lean Phillip was packing that Coleman stove in his pop-up tent because he did not clear the trapezoid at the bottom of the key.
Almost, but couldn't get out of there just in time there, Jay.
Isaac takes it on the right wing on Collins. Collins has been very good on Isaac most of this game. Raddatz goes dribble drive, left baseline. He won't get anything out of that. Inside it goes to Bell. Bell gets it poked away again by Collins, who's crafty inside against bigger guys. Velasi doesn't get it to go, but gets his own rebound. Being guarded by Lee Phillip, needs to shove that back down at him. Won't get it to go. Velasi gets away with a push-off. No, he doesn't. Timmy Cook catches him. Second foul on Velasi.
pulled a chair away from underneath him on the first attempt.
Yeah, he did. Did you notice that? It was was it Lean that pulled it away or Collins?
Because it was. I think it was Collins.
It was just enough that instead of fighting him, he just got around him, and Valesi was looking for a little leverage by pushing him off, couldn't get it, and then he ends up fouling Lean Phillip. Well, they've extended this defense now. It's still a 2-3, essentially a 2-3 matchup. Oh, there's a tough pass by Collins. Turnover to him. Fire from long range. Tyndale can't get it to go. Tip out by, and it was only 5 seconds left on the clock as fighting for it was Valesi. Well, the Lancers have their lead trimmed ever so slightly. They lead by 19 at 56-37, coming to the last two-minute intermission here, or two-minute break between the third and the fourth quarter.
Coach Oliver looking to his assistants saying, are you guys seeing something I don't see here? Yes, they're up 19, but again, that put-away factor is not there yet. I think that's something Coach Oliver's going to work with his team. He's looking around right on the floor saying, where do we got to be here? Like, where's my guards got to be? Why aren't we getting off the ball a little bit quicker? On the other side there, Coach Oliveira using everybody in his lineup. Like, the poor guy's gotten everything, used different defenses. Well, I can't really say that. He used a 2-3 defense pretty much the whole night, but has given everything he's had at the Lancer defense. And, you know, they've responded quite nicely, though, on the other end.
Coach Oliver working with a seasoned crew of associate coaches. His lead assistant is Barry Amlin. Barry has been working with Coach Oliver since he got here, has really been instrumental in developing a streamline, if you will, or a funnel of players both from the junior college and high school ranks, local players as well. Last year, Coach Larry Loback, Coach Supreme, if you will, from the high school ranks here in Essex County. He coached at St. Anne's for 20-some-odd years, numerous championships there. Sean Bacall and Corey Boswell are the graduate assistants, and they're on staff with him. And nice of Coach Oliver as he involves them prior to his final chat before the fourth quarter.
Some stats here from the third quarter. Leading all scores for the game, Enrico Delaretto with 15 points. Junior Santalo with 11 himself. On the boards, though, Ocentello and Phillip both with 8 boards apiece. On the other side of the ball, though, with York Lions, leading off scores is David Tyndale with 10 points. And on the cleanup on the glass is Nick. How do you say his last? I still can't do his
last. Tefezich.
Tefezich. Sorry, folks. Still trying to get it.
Let me know what Tyndale's shooting percentage is.
Tyndale's shooting percentage. He's 4. He's 3 from 9 from the floor, 0 for 4 from beyond the arc, and 4 for 5 from the free throw line.
So his 10 points, half of which from the charity stripe, have been really hard earned. He's known for his three-point shooting, and he's 0-for from the three-point line. Credit, Lancer defense.
Lancer defense holding the York Lions to a 28.6 field goal percentage for the entire game so far.
Just early into the fourth quarter, and now they come out man-to-man. A little bit of pressure and trap from the York Lions. McQueen pulls up. Jamal for 2. Bottom of the well for him. Mid-range jumper. Nice feed from Lean Phillip. Very unselfish. Lean is with the ball. Isaac with it on top, being guarded by Collins. This matchup has taken place most of this competition. Raddus just can't get his hands on it. Looked to me like a nice tip away, and first credit goes out there to Malcolm. Got his hand on that loose ball. Raddus wasn't able to handle it.
Well, we have a quick second here in break in action. Sean Hussein wants to give a shout-out to Pento Gravo from Bully. His message is, after Lancers win, I need a Bud Light. just commenting us as we're doing great here on the broadcast.
Well, you better bring us a Bud Light, too. We just called 2 games in a row.
Yeah,
maybe that's what's going to help your throat.
Hey, you know
that's what it is,
maybe that's what I need.
We need to get a beer for you. That's all right. Jamal McQueen going for a second in a row. It won't go. It's deep. Great rebound by Lean Phillip, but it's not handled well as Justin Bell comes in and swoops it away from him. Nice rough rebound by Bell. Isaac to the rim, and he somehow finds a way to drop it over the top. Good work by Isaac going to the tin there. 19-point lead maintained by the Lancers. 9 minutes left in the competition. Gabriel on the right wing goes to Isaac Kwan. Isaac Kwan across the top to Junior Alcantolo. Gets a little bit of handle problem from Tyndale. And he finds a way to get it go in. If you can do it ugly, just make it happen. And he did. He found a way to get it to the bottom of the well.
Liam Phillip there playing almost so much like Isaac Kwan. He's throwing a couple of Isaac Kwan name drops in there, JK. Gotta love it.
Johnson goes to Tyndale. Tyndale being guarded by Gabriel. Moves dribble drive left on him. Over to Isaac in the corner. Isaac goes for two shots in a row. Can't get it to finish. Johnson's inside and gets his first basket of the night. Nice work by Nate Johnson.
Very recipient of a nice little
Sorry, Robinson. On the top. Well, they're back to that 2-3 here now, Vince. Good rotation by the Lancers. Gabriel and Junior Osantolo will trade sides. McQueen's inside to kind of break up that zone. Oh, stolen. He's careless with the ball, is Lean Phillip. You got hands the size of frying pan. You got to hold on to that thing. Isaac takes it right to the basket. Jamal McQueen gets out of the way and lets him lay it in. Needs to extend that arm a little bit more there. A 60-43, 17-point lead for the Lancers.
The first words out of Coach Oliver's mouth are, got to protect the ball.
Could have been called for a charge as Justin Bell did take it there as a floater by Collins, and he let himself go at the end. There is Lean Phillip. Goes right to the basket. Robinson with the foul. Smart by him. He wasn't going to let that weak stuff go to the basket.
Wholesale changes coming shortly for the Lancers here. Oh, here they come right now. Enrique Delorado checking in. Same with Otley. We also have King and
Matthews.
First one goes down. Coach Oliver, you know, telling his bench, you know, needs a little bit more. You know, he's not worried about the lead here. He's more worried about the way they're executing. And I think that's, you know, as any, you know, championship team, any team that wants to win a championship, that's the little things you got to worry about.
Well, the Lions are being just pesky enough to make the Lancers look poor in some of their execution, some of their sets. Lancers are moving well against the zone. They're just not finishing well. Osantolo had to do a little bit of a dipsy-do and an ugly finish to even get that last basket to go through. Robinson fires from outside. That wasn't a well-balanced shot. Rebound goes into, looks like, Rattis. Rattis kicks it to Tyndale. Tyndale being guarded by Delaretto. He pulls out to think about it. I don't know what he's holding the ball for. His team is trailing by 19. He fires it from 40. 45?
Oh, go 46
and his coach leaves him on the floor. That just looked really strange to me. There's no earnestness. There's no a sense of desperation by the Lions as they sit back in their zone and fire 40-foot threes.
What I don't understand is why he's pulling back with 3 seconds on the clock.
Oh, good defense by Rattis. Picks up that knockaway on Evan Matthews. Falling out of bounds. Waiting and waiting. And credit the defense of Otley there, who was guarding Robinson. Robinson, the first-year player, wasn't able to come right to Rattis, who was falling literally out of bounds. And Kevin Greenwood caught him stepping on the line for the infraction. Token D. No pressure whatsoever by the York Lions. Not sure I agree with this. University level sitting back in a zone defense when you're trailing by 19 points. Deep into the shot clock, 6 seconds left. Gives out to Delaretto. Delaretto straight up jumper. Finds the bottom of the well. Another three-pointer for him. He's been hot most of the night. Hottest in the first quarter. And still productive here towards the end.
Delaretto giving a point there to Osantolo.
Yeah, who was unselfish. Osantolo could have shot that with about 6 seconds left. And it wouldn't have been any harm in doing so. New shot clock, right to the basket. Isaac.
Body's going all over.
Well, now, you know, it seems maybe a little bit too late, but Isaac and Tyndale are playing with a little bit of that desperation that's needed when you're trailing by 20.
She's under six minutes remaining here.
Nice communication. Nice look over the top to Christie. Christie can't get it off. Jumps back, can't find it there. Rebound comes out to Otley. Otley and Osantolo on the wings. Ball didn't hit the rim by Christie. They fight for it. Christie goes down hard. Check the floor. He might have dented it. There it is right there. Nice dunk flush by Isaac. Christie's beside himself. Felt that he was thrown down. If you look at the replay after this game, Evan Matthews is the one that crashed into him, so there is no foul on the play.
Taylor was slow to get back on the play there. Look, might have got a shot there where the sun don't shine.
He's giving it the ESPN Monday Night Football. Come on, man. Right now, how am I not getting a call? Here we go. Delaretto on the wing. He drives. He fires off the rim. I think they're going to call charge. Yes, they are. Tim Cook says that floater is going to cost you. I believe it's his fourth.
Fezzich.
No, it's his fifth. And that's the end of the night for Delaretto. Got caught in the air. kind of halfway through. Oliver doesn't agree with it. Call was made by Tim Cook. It seemed to me from this angle to be the right call. 65-47, 18-point lead. Halfway through the fourth, Lancers lead. That's got to be a charge then the other way. They called it at one end. Wasn't it there? No, it's not. Evan Matthews did not get out in time to take that charge. Wow.
That'll be his third foul there, J.K. Evan Matthews. No, luckily, still we're in the fourth quarter here, so not too much to worry about. But if that came any earlier, we could have been in some serious trouble.
Well, it didn't turn into the back-and-forth barn burner we had last night, because it seemed to me like the Laurentian Voyagers just came with that tenacity, was able to extend their defense long enough to even take the lead in the fourth quarter on the Lancers. The York Lions have decided to sit back in that 2-3 zone and never really have threatened. Let's see if they can cut the lead, as you do see Tyndale take his expertise to the foul line. He just shoot it at a 70% clip.
Quick shout out to Dean
on his
here.
14th point.
Dean emailing us all the way from Ingersoll. I just want to give a shout out to her uncle, his uncle Holly from Ingersoll, watching him live. They're big Enrico Deloretto fans.
Well, they're not going to see much of him from now, as the London native goes to the bench. He gets the hatchet award. Five fouls for him. Long range for Collins. Finds the front of the rim. The home bounce on the new rims for Josh Collins.
Thanks again there to Dean for emailing us. We appreciate it. And any listeners out there, SSNWindsor@hotmail.com. We'd love to hear from you.
Robinson goes right side. Gives it off to Velizzi. Velizzi does get the hoop. Sorry, doesn't get the hoop, but he gets the harm. And it's Christie, who couldn't buy any love at the other end. Now he's like, come on, man. You don't call it at the other end. You got to call it on me here. Where's the love? Well,
probably the best part of Monday Night Football.
He's in his first year at the Lancers, second year of eligibility, and just not quite used to the calls here at this southern tip of Canada. Valesi makes the second. Nice stroke by him. Thin, tall, 6'7", 175 pounds, and that's a gracious 175 from Woodbridge, Ontario. Christie goes inside to Evan Matthews. He gets held the whole way. Nice pass by Christie. He was determined, and I love the high-low look. The Lancers will run cutters from both of their smalls. They're off guard and they're small forward. Sometimes they'll cut right across. Sometimes they'll come back. While they're doing that, the Lancers then send one big to the high post, and the other big flashes low, and it's a nice give and go by the high-low post.
When it works, it's a thing of beauty.
Another fine coaching job by Coach Oliver there, keeping his team moving in transition on offense. You must make the zone move in order to create openings, and they're doing a good job of that. 69-51, Lancers lead, 4:27 left.
Credit Coach Oliveri, definitely trying to do everything in his power to help his team win here tonight.
There's a foul. What is he doing? Even the crowd is throwing his hands up. Actually, I think that King Gabriel got himself just a little bit out of control and might have slipped. He got up and knew he was coming out there.
We gotta say though, Jay, in the last four games, we've seen about at least one of those per game. Someone going up, just fouling someone, shooting a three ball, which in basketball makes no sense to me, but it's kind of surprising.
I think it is three. I think you're right. Wow. First one won't go.
Lancer fans a little rowdy behind us. Gotta love it. Imagine the CIS championships back in March there, Jay.
Is it politically correct to say that the cheerleaders are shaking their pom-poms?
I would say yes.
Yep. Nice form.
I concur with that statement there, Jay.
Makes good on the second. Tyndale for the third of three. Nothing but the bottom of the net. Scorches it. 16-point lead for the Lancers. 4 minutes left in the competition. Arias back in the game for the Lancers. He looks inside to Christie. Christie wants to go to Lean Phillip. Phillip holds off Robinson like he's just a wet rag. No problem there. I really like Christie at this high post position. He's determined to stuff it in the oven and let it go to work.
That's exactly right. He just loves to give the ball to Lean Phillip.
Last time it was Evan, this time it's Lean. Nice work by him. Oh, right there. Good work by Junior Osantolo. He took an elbow right to the rib by Tyndale. Wow, we'd love to get a replay on that. Not quite in our scope of broadcasting. There's a Coach Oliver arguing for it right there. You saw it. It was right in front of you, reading his lips. How did you miss that? Junior jump-hopped right in front of the hard-charging Tyndale and didn't get the call. 3:48 left. Timeout on the floor called by the York Lions.
And that's twice now that Coach Oliver not happy with what he sees from the officiating staff.
That's not unusual, by the way.
No, truly not. But still, Coach Oliver let himself be heard on that sideline there.
Hey, Dave.
My broadcast partner here, JK, just up and leaves me for a few seconds here, trying to make sure, trying to get some sideline reports here. But Coach Oliveri overall, I feel honestly as a person in basketball, you got a feel for him tonight. Really giving everything that he can with the team that he has, and just right now can't keep up with the Poland Lancer offense. Coach Oliver though, really not happy with his players' performance. Yes, they might be up here 18 points, but it's not something that Coach Oliver is really worried about. He's more worried about executing and the small things in the game that make the big picture that much better. So we'll see how the Lancers close out here with 3:48 remaining as. Coach Oliveri and Coach Oliver both looking for ways to go on positive notes here as the game winds to a close.
Ball's shake, up. Rattle, and roll won't go for Isaac there. Lancers come out on the break, led by Lee Phillip. He travels. Nice work by Tyndale to sneak underneath him. Oh, they're having a little bit of words there. A little bit of smile, a little bit of competitive camaraderie there between David Tyndale and Lee Phillip. Shot clock. Oh, okay, that's what it is. Tim Cook saw that the shot clock had not restarted for some strange reason. 19 seconds now on the shot clock. Lancers would really like to see the clock keep rolling here as game doesn't have a sense of urgency, mainly because York doesn't have a lot of answers for the athleticism and play by the Lancers. We should also note that the 12th player in this particular game. But we've got Michael Godfrey in the game. There's been a Godfrey sighting. He's battling inside right now, ladies and gentlemen.
There he is, number six.
So 12 for 12 players have now entered the game for the Lancers. 18-point lead, 3:24 left. Mike is the consummate team player as he has worked so very, very hard, not only to be on the team but to develop his skills. He's out of Wallacetown, and he played for West Elgin. Isaac can't get it to go. Lean Phillip with the rebound. He gives it off to Collins. Oliveri. Collins wants it. Collins wants Osantolo not to drop so low on the baseline. Lean Phillips is going to work. He's in the kitchen. He's letting it cook. He goes over. There it is. Oliveri can't get it to go. He's desperate for his first basket in front of the home crowd here at the St. Denis Center.
Osantolo again being very unselfish, just in the rock off as soon as he gets it.
I said Oliveri, I meant Aria. Drive by Christie. Nick to Fezic goes right up and tries to flush it over top of Mike Godfrey. Mike was in a good help-out position but did get called for the foul. His first. Mike's officially in the book for time, and now he's got a stat.
A little smile comes across his face. Maybe knowing what you just said there, Jay. But it's good to see Godfrey on the court here, especially with 2:45 remaining. Maybe Coach Oliver wants to see what the youngster has to offer. Tefetovic's first won't drop. Second one's on its way.
Tefetovic gets the second one, 71-54. Now they come out with their 2-2-1 pressure with 2 minutes and 42 seconds left. Now they're going to show pressure that the Lancers have gone to their bench. Godfrey goes to the basket. He can't get, needs to protect that. Nice weak side or drop-in defense by Bachman.
Kind of strange to why they're using that pressure so late in the game now. Maybe could use it about 5-6 minutes ago, but.
King Gabriel takes it across over the top. He's going to set it up. Godfrey goes to high post. He's going to work with Lean Phillip. Junior Osantolo pulls it back and fires with the shot clock wearing down. He scores it from three-point range with 3 seconds on the shot clock.
Oh,
Let that one go, Paul. That was an inbounds play that should not have been allowed to go back in, as Robinson took it from inbounds and went back, inbounds and went back out of bounds with it. Robinson on the wing. Tefetich takes it on top, being guarded by, goes right by Godfrey. Too easy. Nick scoops and droops, but can't get it to go. Valesi. He shoots and misses. King Gabriel has, there's Aria. He takes it coast to coast and finishes round the back and right to the tin. Nice job there by Hanek Aria.
Nice soft toucher on the rim there. Really, really pays dividends in the end.
Well, the Ottawa native got away from Dave Smart and the national champion Carlton Ravens.
How? I don't know.
But... 76-54 for the Lancers. 1:30 left in the game. Crossover, hard dribble drive there by Indahindu. He kicks it back out, and the basket is good. I believe that was that Valesi again?
That was Tefetich, actually.
Oh, Tefetich knocked that down. Nice job there.
Nice little footwork, nice footwork there to spin to the inside, and a little button baby hook.
I'm pretty sure there's a fine Serbian connection up there. There's from the Baltics anyway for the York Lions. 2-2-1 pressure, 20-point lead for the Lancers. King Gabriel doesn't get it across in 8 seconds. That's a little harsh. Quick count by Timmy Cook, and the shot clock didn't give us any help there. As sometimes you can look up and compare shot clock to the referee's clock. Oh, that's the way to make up for it. Aria takes it himself, grabs, scrapes, and fights for it, and he gets it off the glass for another 2 points.
Took a little longer than usual there, Jay, but eventually falls down through the twine for two.
Hanek the superhero, Aria. Nice job by him to find a way to get that thing into the bottom of the basket. Last minute of play in the contest. Ihendiu shakes and bakes. Can't get it to go there as hard. And aggressive defense by Jared Malcolm. Nice work by him. Boy, that whippy native really found a way to just keep Ihendiu off the boards. Ihendiu off the boards.
So while we have a break here in action, I'd like to send a shout-out to Dougie Howard, emailing us from Ingersoll. Just wants to give a shout-out. He says it's from Doug the Punisher Howard and the Aunt Saj from Ingersoll. Mentions for Enrique Del Rico, Del Rito fans, and he says, we are jamming. Loves the commentator from us. Thinks we're the best amusing commentators in Canada right now, Jay.
That's
not too bad, eh?
Write it in on the SSN network. Currently, your rating's a little higher than we got last year. We were at number 7 last year on the SSN network, but it's always good to call the game, have a little bit of fun, and the unique part about calling the SSN network is to involve our audience. We love doing that. We love getting the shout-outs,
whether it's
Ingersoll, Israel, or Surrey, British Columbia. We love hearing from you out there, ladies and gentlemen, and calling the action is what we do. I'm J.K. Kennedy, and the color commentator is none other than Vinny Liberti.
Again, folks, you still got some time here to email us in, ssnwindsor@hotmail.com. Love to hear from you. Last-minute shout-outs coming in our way. We always give shout-outs to our fans, as always. Here live, bringing to the action courtside at the nostalgic Sinema Center here in Windsor, Ontario.
78-56, comfortable margin for the Lancers. 49 seconds left. They've cleared their benches. All non-starters are on the floor at this point. Likewise, most of the non-starters, other than Tefetich, is on the floor for the York Lions. Ihendiu fires up that long-air shot. He had to. Not really his fault, as there was only 9 seconds remaining on the shot clock when they inbounded that ball. And
when you empty a bench like that, that's usually what you end up with, eh?
Yeah, we got to fire this one. Nice shot, Malcolm. It won't go. Oh, almost a rebound for Michael Godfrey. Buchanan. He shakes and breaks on McQueen. McQueen gets his big hands up. I think he got a piece of that. That looked like that ball changed directions. McQueen's going to flush this. Oh, no, he won't. Got a little wrong-footed there as Buchanan does get back after his errant shot. Nice pass. Long pass from Michael Godfrey. Should get credit for the assist there as it led directly to a basket.
Definitely nice finish there.
There's not going to be a call here to finish this game. The referees want to go home, too. Bank shot won't go. Rebound goes to McQueen. McQueen to King Gabriel. King Gabriel just shakes, bakes, holds onto it, finishes it off. 24-point victory for the Lancers, holding the York Yeomen, the York Lions, under 60 points.
Almost
with the whole game without calling them Yeomen. And there it is, ladies and gentlemen. But to hold an OUA team to under 60 points, regardless of Coach Oliver's angst at some of the defensive possessions that the Lancers had, that's still a pretty good showing for the Lancers. Score 80, hold the other team under 20. I wouldn't mind that each and every timeout.
Yeah, you got to give credit to both the Windsor Lancers and their nonstop change in offensive strategies, but then also Coach Oliveri throwing pretty much everything he had at the Windsor Lancers, and for the Lancers to hold that off was just a tremendous effort in their part as well.
Well, I think that the tail of the tape is that the Lions just didn't have it physically, man-to-man wise, to match up with the Lancers. They're just the physicality was not there. The athleticism advantage goes to the Lancers, and the matchups were just not to Coach Oliveri's liking. Thus, he sat back in his zone for most of the contest.
And to wrap up the game stats here, Enrique De Loreto leads all scorers with 18 points. Rotami Osuntula.
Well, 40-some points in two nights. Not bad. Not a bad weekend for Enrico.
Osuntula finished off with 16 himself. Liam Phillip leads all. He ends up with a nice double-double with 10 points and 10 boards himself.
Wow.
On the Lions side, Raheem Isaac ends up with 17 points. Followed closely right there by David Tyndale with 14 of his own. Clean up on the glass nicely with Nick Tefidich with 6 rebounds. Overall, the York Lions shooting a rough 29.9% from the floor, but again, even almost as rough, 4.8% from beyond the arc. But the Windsor Lancers showing a nice even spread with a 47.8% from beyond the arc, from the field, and 42% from beyond the arc, going for 11 for 26.
Two nights of good shooting should bode well, as the Lancers now must go on the road for two consecutive weekends for crossover. The first is the nation's capital. Then they'll finish off in Toronto. I believe they play Ryerson and Toronto, and back here basically in three weekends.
Yes.
Before we come back at you, ladies and gentlemen, on the SSN Network. Just want to keep it simple and tell you, love to have you come back at us, ladies and gentlemen. I'm J.K. Kennedy, and in the color chair is Vince Liberti. Happy to say the Lancers pulled off two this weekend. We'll be back in 3 weeks to make the call between the Lancers and their opponents.
Until then, we'll see you later, folks.
They're on the road for how many?
He won't be back here for 3 weeks.
Yeah, almost 3 weeks.
4 games.
Yeah.